everybody. We are so close to finishing our family room remodel, and we are all so excited about that. Thousands of you have already given us your thoughts on what furniture style you think would look best in our family room. However, we need to lay the foundation first. So here to help us choose the perfect rug for our room is Ken.
Hello. Hey. Yes, rugs are super important because they're the base, as you said. They're the foundation for a room. And so often, I hate to say it, people get it wrong. There are little mistakes, just principles that people need to know when choosing it, because it can undermine an entire room if you have the wrong rug.
This is one of those things where there's a wrong and a right when it comes to design.
I've always found it, like, who's the rug police? Who says I've done it wrong?
Well, he's standing right over there.
Rug police.
All right, okay. So then we do have some basic questions then.
All right.
What are the guidelines? I never understand. I'm probably guilty. Are you supposed to put all your furniture on the rug? Is some of it supposed to be on the rug? Are the front legs supposed to be on? Is the
I never know. The age-old question. So it is possible to have a rug that is too big for a room. I have never seen that, though.
Okay.
Usually people do the other thing. It's too small. You want to make sure that you can get the biggest rug you can within your budget that will fit a room. You want to make sure that there's at least 3 inches between your rug edge and the wall, but besides that, go as big as you can.
You can go as close as 3 inches to the wall. That's
right.
A lot closer
right.
than I thought. So, that's
so like, you know, this thing. So, here on this living room, we have, you want to make sure, ideally, your entire sofa, all 4 legs, your coffee table, and any side chairs, occasional chairs you have, all sit on. If you can't get a rug that big or it's out of your budget, get one that at least it goes 6 inches under your sofa, like the front legs are on it.
Beautiful.
And same thing with the chair, but don't go any smaller than that.
Okay.
When it comes to a dining room,
Okay. Right.
You wanna make sure, you don't want just the table on there, so I call it the table magic carpet ride. No, you want it to go under the table and all of the chairs, enough
really?
So that when you push back from the table, your rug is still on. Because otherwise,
oh
pet peeve of mine.
Okay.
Pet peeve when I'm pushing away from the dining room table and you gotta get the chair
right.
gets
and then boom, yeah, right, no. You can't get it back
and
on.
It also ruins the carpet, by
well,
the way, because
probably
you
does too.
Right.
People are tripping all over the place.
Exactly. Table, all chairs on it. Now for the bedroom, what you want for a bedroom is, and it's a little heartbreaking because the majority of the bedroom rug you don't see, it's under the bed. But you do want to make sure it goes under your bed and all the way to the side. So that
nice.
When you get out of bed on either side, your feet hit carpet.
Okay.
Same distance on the foot of the bed. Now, if you can't do that, a little cheat, which I've done, is get smaller rugs or runners and put them on either side of the bed.
Okay.
If you don't want to spend that huge money on most of the rugs.
And I'd say, if you're not going to see most of that rug, don't spend a lot of money.
Right.
Make it a rug that's a little more inexpensive.
Right. Exactly. Exactly.
Yeah.
There's something to be said of like getting out of bed in the morning and putting your feet on the
rug. Exactly.
Oh,
a cold hardware or something
exactly.
like that.
Oh,
I like where this is going, everybody. All right. So different rooms. Different amount of foot traffic, which would probably lead to different materials required,
right.
too, right?
And let's talk about that, talking about comfy. So often with rugs, and unfortunately, durability and comfort kind of cross. And so sometimes you get more comfort, your durability is not going to be
okay.
So let's talk about some different styles here. So the most durable is something that's going to be like a natural fiber or faux natural fiber, like a coir, a sisal,
right.
a seagrass, like these two on the bottom.
These will take a licking. I've had lots of sisal.
They'll never wear down.
Never.
They won't show footprints. You can't clean them, though.
I know.
So you don't want to put them in a dining room or somewhere where there might be food or liquids.
They really, the fibers really absorb.
Yeah. They'll repel right. some naturally, but you're not. But it's very durable. Also not good if you're like a floor napper. Because it's not.
Oh, they're so uncomfortable.
They're scratching. So
if you want, but they're really uncomfortable.
I obviously am a floor napper.
You've seen me at home too. I'm with you, Ken. Okay.
Oh, so then you have the pattern across your face. This is not a good one.
You can then go up a little bit to something that's a cut pile, which is going to be softer and durable.
Nice.
And these come in a zillion different patterns, colors.
Okay.
After that, you can go with something that's like a sculpted. So it's a combination of lower pile and higher pile. Like, let's say if you want a full cream rug,
mm-hmm.
that's going to show a lot of dirt. It's going to show a lot of footprints. But if you get it sculpted in cream, you add a little bit of texture, and that shadow is going to hide some of the stains, hide the footprints, so you get best of both.
Yeah, that's a great idea. I didn't even
think
of that.
The most comfortable, and I think the least durable, is something like a shag. Super, super comfortable, super long. It hides dirt, but you need a super strong vacuum cleaner to suck all that stuff up.
Sure.
And then you really do have to pull out the 70s carpet rake to keep it fluffy
yes,
and to keep it
you
light.
Too.
So those are your
options from most durable to least durable.
Exactly.
All right, so now that we have that covered, how do we decide the pattern that matches the rest of our style? I always get so confused there.
And you know what, I'm always a basic rug. I like my rug to sort of let the furniture shine. But a lot of people, if you have very basic, modern, clean furniture, then you can have a carpet that's a work of art. So it's sort of a balance of what's in your room and what's not. You don't want everything competing. So let's take a look at our different furniture styles.
Okay.
So let's start with coral reef. Now with coral reef, because that sofa is so classic,
it's really
and doesn't have a lot of pattern, same thing with the coffee table, you could bring a pattern in there.
Like I would a Persian rug even.
You could do a Persian rug, but I would do almost something a little bit more modern or like a trellis shag, something like this.
Okay.
Because that softness, I think, would help to balance out some of those solids and sort of a nice big graphic pattern that sofa could handle.
Okay.
Let's look at our next one, which was the secret garden.
I love this one, too.
Because we have the pattern pillows, we have a coffee table that's got some curve to it, I would go with something that was very simple. I would go with, like, one of the natural fiber rugs, because I think also in that sort of secret garden feel, bringing in a little bit of outside fiber naturalness will sort of help with that sort of
the vibe.
It sort of goes with the tone.
Right,
the essence
it does.
Of that, right?
That's nice.
Exactly.
I like that.
Now, with Writer's Haven, because that is so dark and so
masculine,
a little bit towards the masculine, I would actually put a feminine rug in there. Something like this cut pile Jacobean that we
this
looked at. Right, that has that
interesting
pattern.
Interesting. So go against what that is.
Because otherwise, you're going to be so into that masculine dark, but do something that has some refined pattern.
Right.
And it's also a very classic. A Jacobean or Oriental carpet is going to be very classic, which fits in with that whole library feel.
Now, I was going to say, or lawyer's office.
Exactly.
Is what it reminds
exactly.
Me of.
So you get that feel.
Do you know what my big takeaway from all this is?
What's that?
Well, we need some help choosing our furniture,
so we can get our rug.
What style would look best in here? So from that, we can go with the rug. Right?
Exactly.
Right. And also, don't forget, this will actually be the last week that you all at home can help us finish the renovation of our family room. So please go to our website and tell us which furniture design you think would look best in our room. Is it the bright and airy coral reef that really is so beautiful? It reminds me of the summertime, right?
Exactly.
The colorful and natural secret garden, equally as gorgeous.
Oh, I love that.
Or the dark and cozy kind of masculine writer's haven.
Okay, we know how she feels about that one.
I love that one.
Listen, don't let her opinion sway your choices, everybody.
You know
give us your opinion. HallmarkChannel.com. This is your last week to enter the Hallmark Channel's Renovation Sweepstakes for a chance to win one of our weekly prizes, $500, with a grand prize of $50,000. Please tell us what you think.